match the flow, match the hoes, your ass get blasted, so.
Walking down the street, and my all stars, and my khaki suit, doing what I do. Walking down the street, smoking chronic, and my black loops, looking all blue.
There's a certain story, I think, you know, kind of like really when he would like go into the backyard in my grandma's house and play with like rats and pick up dead rats and shit like that, you know. And my grandma, you know, my grandma, Big Mama scared. She ain't fucking with no rats. She's like, you know, and she would like be like, Jason, go get the, you know, go get the little, and this nigga be out there, go scooping them right up, you know. She like, you're kind of like, you're game for anything. That's kind of like where it kind of started from. I think he took to that.
He's a giver. Niggas no game. Jason L. Taylor, the niggas a giver. He said on the doctor's app, nigga, I spent 1.5 on my niggas. That wasn't some shit he just made up.
Don't get it twisted. He's definitely an intellectual and very smart individual.
I think there's two issues, you know. There's game as an artist, and then there's game the person.
You can definitely find negative in anyone, but I think there's a lot of positive in game. And you can see where he helps a lot of people, like he helped myself.
I am who I am. I'm a man. I'm a son. I'm a brother. I'm a father. I'm hip-hop. First thing that I can ever remember in my life would be a memory of me on my father's shoulders. He had this big, big, big fucking afro, man, and we were at like some music fest, and I think like LA Dream Team, African Bambaataa, and the Sugar Hill Gang, and all these cats were playing there. And I just remember being, you know, on a big grassy area on my father's shoulders, and I can just remember how good it felt to be so high, you know, on the top of anything was real big, and I felt protected on his shoulders, high up above all the rest, and just say I never came down. My pops was around when Tookie was around, and you know, I don't know, maybe Tookie started the Crips, maybe somebody else did, who knows. I just know that they were all pioneers of this major catastrophe that we're all entrapped in. And he ran with the Nutty Block Crips, and that's the area that we grew up in the early portion of my life, because that's where my grandfather and my grandmother lived. Post office, and she bust her ass, man. She worked the graveyard shift, and my dad, you know, I'm pretty sure he was out hard working too. Just wasn't, you know, it wasn't working for the government. It wasn't working, you know, real man. I mean, not a real man's job, but a working man's, you know, job. My dad ran the streets, and he's what I like to call a night crawler. You know what I'm saying? It gets late night, and you know, my dad starts crawling, and he came back with what he needed to, you know, provide for his family, and so it was all good. with my mom and the rest of us because they were both providers in the early stages.
I loved Tom Jones, and so we went to a club called the Carolina West, and we used to hang out there on the weekend. It was this real nice club by the airport, and they used to have like telephones on the table where you know, if you seen a guy or a girl, you could call the person on the phone or whatever. And so when I went into the club, like the second time I went in there, I seen him dancing on the stage, and I was like, oh my God, he looks like Tom Jones. And everybody was like, hey, leave him alone. And I was like, no, I gotta have Tom Jones. And so that's basically how we met. He was sitting at a table, and it was like, I think his phone line was like number 23, and I picked up number 23, and the rest was history.
Me and Lynette started hanging out together and, you know, being a boyfriend, girlfriend thing, and we had our son. Yeah, so I don't know. I don't knock Miss Lynette. She loved me, and I was a screw up back then, you know.
Well, later on in life, what I, you know, found out from talking to him was he said that, you know, it was the drugs that he was using. Because, you know, in the beginning, we had a very, very nice relationship, a very nice, loving relationship with our kids. And, you know, I guess it was drugs. Like I said, I never used drugs. I don't know the effect that they do to people. I've seen people on drugs, so I'm going to take that for its excuse.
I wish that someone had schooled me as a young man growing up in the art of love. And, you know, the art of taking care of a woman. You know, I had to learn that on my own through trial and error. You know, I hope that Lynette finds in her heart to forgive me one day, because I wish I could have loved her the way she loved me.
One thing about my dad, man, is that he's always been a guy with a big heart, you know? But when you have a big heart, you can have big other things. You can have a big ego, you know what I'm saying? You could have, you know, big bad intentions too, you know? My dad's a poet, which I'm pretty sure that's where, you know, my knack for, you know, lyrics and writing come from.
The night began serene with beauty, and there was mystic magic in the air. The clouds, the sky, the soulful sounds, the black nightlife were everywhere. I slid behind the steering wheel so smooth it seemed an act. A sharp young black man, yes I am, in a cold black Cadillac. My mood was just the perfect mood for what I had in store. To catch me a fine young sister. Better yet, three or four. Me and my brother, Big Greg, Big Collar, Greg Taylor. Like I said, he was my, you know, my hero, but unfortunately, my hero went to prison for years and years. So when he got out, he had this big 6-foot white girl with him from Canada. So I told him he could come stay with me. And I was married to Big Face's mother then. But she was 6 foot, and she reminded me of real. I didn't ever understand that, because I didn't want to be with no woman big as me. So I guess prison make you like that. So I just let him come stay with us. But I woke up one morning, my son, little George, was crying, and he said, Daddy, she's stealing my food. She's taking my food. Well, the girl had took his bowl, and she was eating his food. So I even went and woke my brother up and told him, yeah, you know what I mean, you got to get her, and you got to go, man. So he started talking a gang of shit that I didn't really want to hear, and I had to hear, because he was bigger than me. This guy got 24-inch arms. I was listening for a little bit, and then my mouth shot out, and then before I knew it, he had socked me. My girl told me I was out for about 15-20 minutes. But he